So today's presentation, as it shows, network connectivity testing with the T-Bird 5800. So there's two use cases, primary use cases that we're going to talk about. One is in an enterprise environment, someone that just has responsibility to get to that nearest switch. That's what we're going to go over today. Also, another use case might be people troubleshooting connectivity issues, excuse me, when they're trying to do a network performance test. So basically, I cannot loop up that far-end device, so I need to revert back and see where my connectivity is failing. That's what we're going to go over today. I'm going to demonstrate this to you on a copper port at just 1 gig, but most of these capabilities that we're going to go over are available on all the ports all the way up to 100 gig. Another thing to note is the screen that I've got in front of me, yours may look a little different. You can customize the screens so that you've got kind of one-click launch buttons. It's kind of a list of favorites. So for today's presentation, we're going to be doing quick check, traffic monitor, layer 3 ping, layer 3 traceroute. So I've got all these loaded into my custom kind of one-click menu, favorites menu. If not, I could go over here and do it. If I don't have it loaded onto the screen already, I could click on Ethernet, I could click on 10.100, and then I could select from the list this way as well. So either way, it's going to get you to the same test. It's just you can go in and customize the unit to load your favorites onto that screen ahead of time. So, all right. So the first test we want to do is a quick check. Click on that and we load that. This is a basic connectivity test that will do local connectivity. And when this loads, in just a second, you'll see that the first thing it's going to do is it's going to go out and it's going to start looking for a T-Bird, for a remote T-Bird. So let this load up. You'll see on the left-hand side it's connecting. It's analyzing, so auto negotiation is on, and I'm showing it's 1 gig at full duplex. So I've got a link. If I go now and start to look, I can click on the start test button. So what this is doing right now is three different scenarios. The first one, it's looking for a loop at the other end of the circuit. It's basically looking for an active loop or a T-Bird that replies to a loop up message, or another could be another Viavi device. So after it goes through that, it's going to fail that because I don't have another T-Bird out there. Now it's going in, it's looking for a hard loop. This is where you have a physical cable attached. You've looped the device back onto itself. Again, it's not going to find anything here, and it's going to move down to the third scenario. This is a soft loop. It's listed on there as permanent. So this is a device that is not a Viavi device. It would have found that in the first one. But it's a device that's in loopback mode. It might be a NID or something that was configured to act as a loopback device. So again, it didn't find anything. The test has gone in. It's failed. On the bottom right, you'll see the remote loop has failed. We didn't find anything. So at this point, I can go in now. If I click on this not what you wanted tab, I can now go in. You'll see in the top left here, there's a VLAN discovery option. If I click on that and run this test again, I'll scan through all the different VLANs. So if the issue is that a VLAN was mismapped, then this would find it and it'll list all those different VLANs that got through. So I'll click on that. I'm going to hit the back button. And again, if I run this test again, and it's obviously I'm not on an enterprise network, so I'm not going to find any VLANs. But now it's going out and it's searching for the VLANs. Again, it's not going to find any, so my list, this table is just going to be empty right now. Any that did get through that it found, it would be listed right here. So, again, first one is a standard loopback. Second test, we click on not what you wanted, and it'll go in and do the VLAN, a scan of the VLANs. All of these tests that we're doing, there's not a lot of information to show, so I won't go into it, but I could click on next and I could generate a test report showing the different information. If it passed and you wanted to save the documentation of it, we could go in, click on report generation, and it would generate a report showing those results on there. So I'm going to hit the exit button. We're going to get out of that. Am I sure I want to exit? Yes. And so the next test I want to go over, it's a layer 2 traffic monitoring. So if I click on that, again, I've got it set up as my just a one click button as one of my favorites. So what this is going to do, one of the first things to note is the LEDs on the left hand side. So this is saying sync acquired and link active are green. So we know that the link came up. So we've got an active link. From there, that's over here on the left, these green LEDs. So we know we've got an active link. This summary screen, right now it's red because I haven't started the test yet. But this is going to show if we were taking errors in the link or if we were just getting garbage out of that port, this would turn red and show us all those errors. On the right-hand side here, this is the auto negotiation status. It's showing that we did pull. Let me restart this test. So we've run the test. This is showing that we did pull 1 gig, 1,000 megabits, 1 gig, and we're at full duplex. So at this point, I've got an active link. Everything is connected properly. I can go in now, and there are some additional tests that I could do. So if you need to troubleshoot further, the toolkit in this bottom right here is going to give us some more tests that we can dive into a little deeper. The three I'm going to focus on today is the cable diagnostics, link connectivity test, and then the protocol analysis. So cable diagnostics, this is a pair test. We'll click on that. There's two different tests we can do to test that cable. So this isn't a cable certifier. We're not doing near-end crosstalk and return loss and testing a Cat 5e cable to certify the installation. What we're doing is we're testing that cable that's being run to the switch. Two tests that we can do. The cable that I've got on my 5800 right now is attached to my router, so it's not allowing me to do this distance test. If I disconnect it from the router, I could do a distance test, and it would tell me that I've got a 3 meter cable being run off the top. A more important test, besides just the length, is this pair test. You'll see it's flashing here. That's because I've got a connection. It knows that I've got I'm connected up. Verdict right now says none. All my information down below is saying it's not available. If I hit the pair test, test in progress, now the verdict has changed to pass, and you'll see down below that the polarity, everything is normal. So this cable is good. It's showing that verdict is passed. All the pairs are good. We've got 1 gig. So my link speed is showing over here on the left as 1,000 meg. So we've got a 1 gig cable, and everything's good. So this is telling me I don't have a cable issue. The cable is giving me good continuity. So again, very minimal data here, but it is showing that the cable is good. I could run a report if I wanted to, same way as on that last screen that I talked about. Click next, and I could go in and generate a report showing that this cable is actually a good cable. I'm going to exit out of here. And now I want to go back into that toolkit. Again, scenario is in an enterprise environment, I've got responsibility to get to that nearest switch. I'm not getting there. Now I've started to troubleshoot. I've gone in, I've done the quick check. Or if I'm trying to do a network performance test and I'm troubleshooting that connectivity, I've got a connectivity issue. So I've gone in, I've done a quick test, tried to loop back. In my case, I couldn't loop back in the situation I'm in, in the configuration I'm in. We've done a cable diagnostics test. We're showing we've got a good link. The link is active. Sync is acquired. The cable is good. So now we're going to go in and do a link connectivity test. So again, cable's giving me connectivity or continuity. So now let's see if the link is good. So when I launch this test, I can go in and I can toggle exactly what it says there. This test will toggle the link activity on and off for visual inspection of which port is connected to the test equipment. So I can set the duration for the link up, link down. I could set it stay on for 5 seconds, go off for 1 second, do this 10 times, go on for 10 seconds, go off for 3 seconds, and do this 10 times or 20 times or whatever. So when I run this test, now I need to physically walk to the other end to look at the switch to see, am I plugged into that right to the right port? And it's going to verify that I've run this cable properly and I've connected it to the right port. So the cable was good. I'm still having some issues. Am I in the right port? I run a link connectivity test. Yep, that port that I'm supposed to be in is flashing. So I know I've got the right port on that switch is connected. It'll eliminate that. Maybe I've plugged it into a port that's on the wrong VLAN on the switch and some cables got crossed. This will eliminate that. But again, the link connectivity test is a physical, you need to physically walk down and see what's blinking. So if I close out of that, go into the toolkit. Now, if the switch has CDP or LLDP enabled, then I can do the same thing by simply using the protocol analysis tool, which is right here. So if I click on that, and again, I've got a slide that I'm going to show you for this. I'm not plugged in on an enterprise switch, so it's not going to support CDP, but I'll show you what it would look like. So this is in your applications, when you are plugged in to an enterprise switch, you would go in here, select CDP or LLDP, click on it, and then start analysis. I'm going to switch over again and just show you what the results would look like, what an actual... So this is a sample of the results for the CDP or for the protocol analysis test. It's as you can see here, it's showing the MAC address for the port that we're on, the device ID. Port number is a big thing here. It's showing it's fast Ethernet, 043. This means it's basically row zero, column 43 on the switch. Showing me my VLAN. I'm on VLAN 11, and then the IP address. So this is the information you'll get. Again, if I was hooked up where I could pull this information, this is the results that I would have seen, and the same for LLDP. So let me switch back over. All right. So we've checked the cable. Continuity is good. We've looked at the link. If we did that link connectivity, we physically walked to the other end, saw where that cable was connected. It was connected in the right port. Or again, if it supports CDP, we can run this protocol analysis and look at the switch port right from the device. All right. So the next one we want to talk about, everything at this point seems to be hooked up properly. Now we want to go in and do a layer three ping test. If I go up to my select test, layer three ping, and there's a couple of things we can set up on this test. So again, on the left-hand side, sync acquired, links active, everything is good. If I click on this setup button in the top right, there's two main tabs here that we want to focus on. One is the Ethernet tab. So if I was on a VLAN and I would need to change this to the encapsulation to show VLAN, if I click on that, just to give you an example, you'll see the VLAN popped up here. I can click on that and now I can enter my VLAN ID. Again, in my case, I'm not on a VLAN. There's also QNQ. It's a VLAN within a VLAN. If I clicked on that, it's going to give me my service provider and my customer SVLAN and CVLAN, service provider and customer VLAN. Again, clicking on either one of those, the information, enter the information in here. Again, I'm going to go to none. And if I go down to IP, if this is set to, you can change your source IP type. I'm going to use DHCP because I'm going to pull an address from my router, but you can also enter a static IP address. Once I click on that, these boxes, these options become ungrayed, and I can enter the information in. But again, I'm just going to click on DHCP and pull the address from my router. Down below, destination type, two options here. I can toggle between pinging an IP address or pinging a host name. So in my case, I'm going to start. I always start and try to ping an IP address first. And I'm going to change this to my gateway is 192.168.1.1. Hit OK. And now I can go back to results. So what this is showing me is, again, on the left-hand side, it's showing the, where am I here? Left-hand side is showing the green LEDs, sync acquired, link active. Summary results are okay. I can also go into this ping and I can change that. Actually, let me start this test. Down below, I'm going to hit ping. And you'll see this is going through. So I'm getting replies for all my requests. I can also go in here, and instead of showing this, I can click on change this to level 3 configuration status. And this is going to show the address I pulled from the router and the DNS address. One other thing down below here, if I want to capture any of this ping messaging, I can click on the capture tab. I can click on start capture. Right now you'll see the buffer, it's going through, it's going to start capturing that. If I didn't have ping turned on, here's where I'd need to turn it on, because right now I'm capturing all this information. I can turn it off. I can go back to the capture, turn the capture off, click on save capture buffer. One of the things here we want to do is make sure we've got this launch Wireshark after saving and click on save. This is going to take that information. It's saving that capture buffer. It's loading Wireshark and loading it into Wireshark. So from here, you can do a deeper dive analysis. You can look at a lot more of the results and go into Wireshark. So very simple. Again, just by clicking on that, save and launch Wireshark afterwards, it automatically opens this up and allows you to go in and do some analysis here. I hit quit to get out of this. All right. So the other thing I want to show is, so I've just pinged my router. I've pinged an IP address, 192.168.1.1. It's internal. But now I also want to check and see if I can ping a DNS server. So before I was just pinging my own router, now I want to leave my home office and get out to the internet, see if I can get outside. So to do that, there's two ways of doing it. I can either go into setup over here on the right, and I can toggle it here. Again, click on host name. In this case, the default that came up was yahoo.com. If I click back on results, you'll see at the top here it went to hostname and yahoo.com. So instead of going into that setup tab, I could have also done it right from here. If I click on that, I can click IP address or hostname. And then if I click on this, I'll click on it, it's going to bring up a box. I can type anything I want into this, any address I want in there. So same thing. I'm going to go in. I can hit go back to actions and ping. And if I go back over to my ping, so again, I'm getting replies for all my requests. I'm pinging. So not only am I leaving, I can do it within the home office, pinging my router, but now I'm also getting outside, out into the internet, and pinging a host name, the DNS server. Same thing here. If I wanted to capture this, I could go in, capture, start capture. That's turned on the capture, so I'm capturing everything right now. Again, you want to just make sure that you are pinging when you're capturing it, obviously. I can go back into capture, turn this off by just clicking on that capture started tab, and then I can go into save capture. And again, if I click on that, launch Wireshark after saving, hit save. Again, it's going to save that information. Launch Wireshark automatically, and I can look at that. So again, I'm just going to quit out of this file, quit. The next thing here is so we've shown pinging a local IP address. I've gone out, I've pinged the DNS server. Everything's good. So now I just want to go in and I want to do a trace route. So I'm going to do a layer 3 trace route test. If I go into select test, again, layer 3 trace route term. I've got the shortcut turned on there. And again, so the service provider that I have in my home office here, they spoof the replies. So no matter what the host name I type in, it could be anywhere in the world, all I show is one hop to get anywhere. So I'll show you actual trace route that's more real world, but I just want to show you how to get to it, and then I can show you what an actual summary or result would look like. So again, key feature, left-hand side, sync acquired, link active, all good there. If I go up into this setup screen, I can go into IP. If I want to load in a static IP address, I can do that. Again, once I select static, it's going to unlock these and allow me to type the information in, or I can click on DHCP. Down below here, I've got IP address, which go into my router, it's not going to show us much. So I'll just show you host name, and we'll try to go to Amazon.com. Go back to my results screen, and at the top, you'll see that it's showing what I'm pinging. Destination type is a host name, destination name is Amazon.com, and now I start my trace route. And miraculously, I get to Amazon.com in one hop. I could change this if you wanted to. We can change this to anything. If I go back to Yahoo and try a yahoo.com, click OK. And again, let's try a trace route to yahoo.com. Boom, one hop. So I'm gonna switch over and let me show you what a real test would look like. You'll see host name at the top, and host where we went to was yahoo.com. So when I just went to yahoo.com, it was one hop. This is what, in reality, this is what it should show. So in this case, there's over 11 different hops to get there. It's got the delay from hop to hop to hop, and the IP address that it went through. So, okay. So again, this is back to mine. It's just showing that one hop. This is a live screen that I'm showing. If I click on that, Fios home router, and it went to yahoo.com. So again, click on that little snowflake icon or whatever that icon is. And it brings me right back to the original, to the main screen. That's kind of the tools that we've got. Again, for that scenario, we're trying to connect to that nearest switch. We're doing network performance testing. We've got some connectivity issues, and we need to troubleshoot and try to narrow it down to figure out exactly what that issue is. So quick check that I went over at the beginning, went through and showed that there were no other devices, no other Viavi devices. It couldn't find another 5800. I then went into that cable test and just did a quick cable test on there, showing just the cable, that the pairing was good. So it kind of eliminated the fact that it was we got good continuity out of the cable. So it wasn't the cable. Went in and did the protocol analysis, the cable diagnostics, the link connectivity, where you physically were blinking the port, you physically need to walk down to the switch and see it, or again, the protocol analysis, if you're running CDP or LLDP, you can see it right from the one T-bird. When all that was good, now we wanted to see, get out, check an IP address, see if we could ping. We were able to then go in and ping a host name. So again, start with the IP and then go to the host name. It showed that I could get out. I got out to the domain, the DNS server. And then also take it one step further. We did trace route to show how many hops, where did we go along the way to get to that address that we were trying to get to.